So in this video, let's take a look at how to find research articles for your dissertation. We're going to look at two methods today, Google Scholar, which is completely free for anybody to use, and a university academic database for which you will need to have a university account. So first, let's go to Google Scholar. Essentially, we just need to enter the keywords in the search bar. Say I am doing a research study about employee turnover and I need literature on this topic. I'll just type in employee turnover and search. Out of the many search results, full text articles are marked with a PDF, so just click on that and we can read the article. We can also save the PDF, of course, if we want to. If we need to cite this article, we can use the automatically generated citation by Google Scholar. We just need to go back to the previous page and click on Cite. It is important to note, though, that sometimes these automatically generated citations contain errors and inaccuracies. So it is important that you check this citation carefully and make sure it is accurate. You may need to do some necessary corrections yourself. What is also useful is the cited by link, which shows you articles that cited this particular article. Because most likely these articles are also related to your research topic, so you might want to give them a quick scan too. And now let me show you the advanced search options. In the advanced search window, we can enter more conditions, limitations, and options in order to further refine and target the literature search. So let's try it out. I'm also going to enter, let's say, hotel industry. And I would like to see articles published after 2000. So there you go. Obviously, these research results are more refined and targeted to my specific topic of employee turnover in the hotel industry. So overall, Google Scholar is pretty simple to use. Just explore it yourself, try different combinations of keywords, play around with it, try the advanced search options. It is all pretty self-explanatory. There are also more advanced features of Google Scholar that I didn't really talk about. What I showed you was just the basic stuff. But even these basic options should be enough for you to get quite some articles for your bachelor's dissertation. So now let's take a look at a university database. I'm going to show you the EBSCO database, which is available for almost all universities and colleges. First, let me log into the Stenden EBSCO page, and if you are a Stenden student, this is how you do it. We're going to go to Stenden. Library. Ebooks. And EBSCO. All right. Business source complete. Let me also log into the University of Groningen EBSCO page. And as you can see, they're almost completely the same. This EBSCO search interface is very easy to use, and it is, in my view, even better than Google Scholar. However, you do need to have a university account to access this. Let's see how it works. I'm going to use the University of Groningen version, but it really doesn't matter because it is pretty much the same interface regardless of which university you're accessing it from. What I would normally do is I choose all the databases to enlarge my search range. So choose databases and select everything. So let's type in the same keywords, employee turnover. It is useful to choose the full text options so that only full text articles will show up. So let's do that. Full text. You might also want to click on the peer-reviewed journals so that we do not have newspapers or magazines and textbooks and stuff like that. Search. In the search results, what I normally do is I go to page options and I choose detailed. So now the abstracts of all the articles are also shown, which means I can just quickly scan through these abstracts so that I can see which articles are more relevant for my research. I can also limit the publication time range, say I am only interested in papers published after 2000. Let's say I have found an article that is useful, so I can click on full text to access the PDF. If I wish to cite this article, I can click on the Cite button. Just like in Google Scholar, we have automatically generated citations in different referencing styles. You know what? Now let me repeat this entire search process in the EBSCO page of Stenden so that you can see the search process is exactly the same. So keywords. Detailed. Article. Cite. There you go. So, with Google Scholar and all these academic databases all available online, as a student, you should never complain to me that you cannot find enough articles for your dissertation. Alright, thank you for watching this Ranywayz random video. Please like and subscribe, and I will see you next time.